Ladies and gentlemen, America's oldest living teenager, Dick Clark.
Thank you very much. You know, when you've been around since the Stone Age, such as I, you begin to think that there are very few one-of-a-kind people around. And then I met Robert Evans. The man is daring, controversial, charismatic. Face it, he is a true original. But more impressive than all of that is this. In 1999, the Library of Congress selected only 75 films to be valued as America's treasures and to be preserved in perpetuity. Bob Evans is the only living producer who can call two of those films his own, Chinatown and The Godfather. Obviously, it's a nice mark. I could, go on and on, but here's a little sample of why Robert Evans is getting tonight's David O. Selznick Award.
Live for always. I will be a millionaire.
I imagine in acting, as in just about everything else, there's also a certain element of luck, isn't there?
Well, luck played a very important part in my career, Ed. I was discovered twice within 3 months, once by Norma Shearer and once by Daryl Zanuck, once in Los Angeles and once in New York. But there's an old proverb, Ed, luck is when opportunity meets preparation.
I've been in this movie racket for 4 decades. And there's only one thing more challenging, complicated, and intriguing. And that's trying to figure out what's going on in a dame's head. I'll tell you this, pal. Any man who thinks he can read the mind of a woman is a man who knows nothing.
And the nominees for Best Female Video are Britney Spears, Pink, Shakira, Ashanti, Michelle Branch.
The 2002 MTV Video Music Awards.
How would I describe my life? Well, let's just say I've lived by the sword and I've died by it too. It ain't easy going from royalty to infamy. I've been shot down, bloody, trampled, accused, disgraced, scandalized. Tough, sure, but I ain't complaining. Nothing comes easy. It's been one hell of a bumpy ride. Does it make for a movie? Yeah, a great one. But it ain't no Disney flick.
The most marvelous party, son.
You bet your ass it is.
Down on you, no man has fallen. Under pressure, brings a feeling down. people on streets.
Included in that piece were lots of great actors. We have one of the greatest of all time with us tonight. He's won everything in sight, including the Academy Award twice, and he's a longtime friend of Robert Evans. Ladies and gentlemen, Dustin Hoffman.
First of all, I'd like to thank Jack Valenti for obvious reasons. Next, I'd like to say this is the last speech, or the next to the last speech. And though it looks like it's a lot, it's a large font for a man my age. In a way, I probably met Robert Evans before I met him. At age 11, Mr. Evans started his illustrious acting career on the Let's Pretend radio show, which I listened to every Saturday morning. We were destined to work together. Even then, we had the same taste. But it wasn't until Marathon Man that I met Bob formally, and now I can thank him publicly for lobbying for me, for Sir Laurence Olivier when no insurance company would insure him because of his illness, and for the creative and courageous choice of Martha Keller, who could not speak a word of English except for phonetically learned lines when I met her for her screen test, and for bringing John Schlesinger, the irreplaceable Conrad Hall, and William Goldman's script, as well as Bob Town, the finest writer of his generation, to write a critical scene to the mix. Robert Evans produced Marathon Man in the fullest sense of the word. I never met a producer like Bob before. I never met a producer like Bob, period. To know him and to work with him is to understand the engine that put Chinatown, Rosemary's Baby, Love Story, The Godfather's 1 and 2, and other films up there on the screen and beyond into film history. Relentless, pathologically enthusiastic, not unlike Willie Loman, as Arthur Miller put it, he's out there on a smile and a shoe shine. A salesman's got a dream. It comes with the territory. One day in the middle of a tough scene on Marathon Man, Bob approached me in between setups and in his characteristic stage whisper said, "I gotta talk to you." Motioning me to a darkened backstage area, he held out an 8x10 envelope that he'd previously held behind his back, and the following scene is forever imprinted. You see this? You see what I have? Yes, it's a script. No, it's not just a script. And raising his eyebrows, this is the finest script I've read in 10 years, maybe 15. And you're the first to get it, okay? Really? I swear to God, you're the first. Not Warren, not Jack. You're the first, okay? Because I want you to have it, Star. Bob liked to call the stars he worked with Star. And when he said it, you felt like you earned it. I said, thank you. Thanks. You're going to read it tonight as soon as you get home. Okay, Star? I said, I can't read it tonight, Bob. I got so many lines to learn for tomorrow's scene. Just give me a couple days. Impossible. I can't. I can't wait. You know why? Because you're the first. Not Jack, not Warren, and they're going to hear about it. It'll be very embarrassing to me. I need you to read it tonight, and you got to get back to me tomorrow. Okay, Star? I can't. Tonight is important. You don't know how important this is. But it's for your career. I'll be honest with you. It's for my career. This could be very big for both of us. And, pointing his finger, I know. I'm the first. You betcha. I'll see you on the set tomorrow, my boy. And as he leaves with a wink and a smile, you're going to thank me, Star. The next day, as promised, Bob was back. He patiently waited for me to finish a setup. I walked over to him. Did you read it? Yeah, he did. You're the first to read it. You know that. I know. You told me. It's terrific, isn't it? I told you. It's the best script I've read in 10 years. I've never had readers' reports like this. I mean, it's a home run. We'll have our pick of directors. What'd you think? Well, it didn't get to me, Bob. I didn't respond to it. Why not? Well, I don't think it works. I think it's a bad script. You know what? You're absolutely right. It's a very bad script, and you're gonna make it a good script. You're gonna fix it. We're gonna both fix it. Just remember, I gave it to you first. You know what I mean? We're gonna fix it, and it's gonna be terrific. It's gonna be a home run. That's a true story. I don't remember the name of the script. I don't know if it got made or not. It doesn't matter. What does matter is that this was the same engine, the same enthusiasm that gave birth to all those films you just saw up there on the screen. A producer's got a dream. It comes with the territory. Bob Evans is simply a man of dreams, a man of heart, a man of passion, a man who loves films and making films as much, if not more, than anyone in this room. In his notes on Death of a Salesman, Arthur Miller said that his play came from images. The image of aging and so many of your friends already gone and strangers in the seats of the mighty who do not know you or your triumphs or your incredible value. Above all, perhaps, the image of a need greater than hunger or sex or thirst, a need to leave a thumbprint somewhere on the world, the need for immortality, and by admitting it, the knowing that one has carefully inscribed one's name on a cake of ice on a hot July day. Bob understands this irony. He has always understood it. It's what makes him Bob. On his notes to himself about himself in his book, Bob said, "Where is everyone?" Dead? Mostly. Wealthy? Some. Destitute? Many. Retired? Suppose so. I ain't seen him. One thing I do know, I ain't dead. I ain't wealthy. I ain't destitute. And I ain't retired. It is with deep pleasure that I present the 2003 David O. Selznick Lifetime Achievement Award to the kid who has stayed in the picture, Robert Evans.
very tough to follow Dustin Hoffman. Is that true, Dustin? True, isn't it, Dustin? You know, looking around this room tonight, conjecture dictates that there are so many people here who deserve this award more than myself. But truth, I stand alone in the history of Hollywood as the only man who started his career as head of a studio and ended up as an animated cartoon. Many have said that David O. Selznick died broke. He didn't die broke. He may have died broke of money, but he died the richest man in this whole industry. For after all, what greater wealth is there than to be remembered? And for time and eternity, the brilliance of Selznick will be never forgotten. But do me a favor, will you, David? Will you ever make it up there? Give me a break. Accept me for once. I ain't a bad guy. And just to think of the name David O. Selznick, you think of a producer, you think of an artist, you think of a man that gave up everything he had to make what he wanted to make. I tried it, I failed, but there's only one, David O. Selznick. How proud I am to look at this and think that I got this award. I thank you all for giving it to me. Thank you.